all the saints and angels.
All the saints and angels bow before your throne, and all the elders cast their crowns before the Lamb of God and say, "You are worthy of it all. You are worthy of it all. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory. Sing, you are worthy. You are worthy of it all. Yes, you are. You are worthy of it all. For from you are all things, and to you are all things. You deserve the glory."
Hello, and welcome to the academyofworship.org YouTube channel. My name's Chris, and today we're talking about what you can say when leading musical worship. Now, before we get started, I want to make sure that we kind of put some ground rules in place here, or at least have an understanding among each other. I'm not going to be covering something that I think is a one-size-fits-all rule. I'm going to be talking about a tool you can add to your tool bag as a musical worship leader that I see missing in some circumstances in some churches. Now, don't hear me as saying that you are not doing something and therefore should. Just understand that I'm explaining a principle or a tool, like I said, that you can use in worship. The second thing I want to say is that all of our faith traditions vary widely, right? We all come from different churches or different denominations, and I don't have to tell anybody out there that one of the most divisive things in a church can be music. So take what you want from this video, use it if you need to, don't if you also don't need to. With all that being said, let's go. The musical demonstration at the beginning of this video is a little different than normal. I was singing in it. The reason I was doing that was to give examples of some of the things you can do while leading musical worship vocally to bring the congregation or those that you're leading in worship into worship and to follow you. Because our jobs as worship leaders when we're leading musical worship is to bring everyone with us, right? We're not a rock star. We're not supposed to be center stage necessarily in the reason that people are looking up there. The reason people are there are to worship Jesus and to give God all the glory. So some of the tools we can use is to say things. One thing I notice when visiting other churches or hearing other worship leaders lead musical worship is that sometimes there's dead spots or it's not totally obvious where we're going next in the song. In a lot of churches, you have projected lyrics or some kind of screen that you're reading, and you're not in a traditional hymns where you can follow the music and know exactly where you're going. And sometimes when a worship leader calls an audible, as it were, and changes something up from maybe what was rehearsed or is not something that's super clear to the person running the multimedia stuff, that can be kind of confusing when they don't hear a vocal cue or don't know where it's going, and there's a lag in the way that the lyrics change on the screen. So in an effort to alleviate this kind of thing, one of the tools you have in your bag as a musical worship leader is to call out what it is that you want people to sing with you. So at the beginning, as I'm just kind of noodling on the intro of the song and playing some chords to kind of set things up, I simply said, "Sing all the saints and angels." So I just gave them the first line that we're going to be singing. It not only tells them what words we're going to be singing if it wasn't clear already, but it also lets them know, okay, we're going to start now. So a simple spoken thing like that, where you just tell them the first couple of words or the first line of a song, can be a huge help for those that are singing along with you. Because remember, the people in the congregation and those that we're leading in musical worship don't have music in front of them. They don't understand necessarily the structure of a song, that it's verse, you know, pre-chorus, chorus, bridge, whatever. They don't understand these sections, so they just need to know without any doubt where it is you're going. The next thing I did was I sung the repeating chorus first line. So in an effort to tell everyone, hey, we're going to be singing this part again, these are the words we're going to be singing, and instead of speaking it, I sang it. Now, this one in particular is a little bit harder to do because if you're not comfortable with your voice and improvising notes that you're not necessarily singing as part of the song or the tune or the melody line of the song, it can be a little bit intimidating to start doing this. So sometimes you can just pick one note in the key and sing it. And the only reason you're doing that is to change things up a little bit, to make it sound a little more musical than just yelling something in a microphone. It sounds like it's cohesive and part of the song. So singing the next line is definitely an option if you're comfortable doing that. And if not, it's something you can practice doing on your own time. Try it. You might be surprised at how easily it comes to you. So a couple of caveats to doing these kind of things and some obvious pitfalls that you want to avoid. One is trying to cram too much into too short a time. What I mean by that is, if you have two lines that are really close to each other, or for example, in the song I was singing, going from the verse into the chorus is a very short gap, and you have to start singing immediately into the chorus. There's no real room there for me to say, okay, let's sing this line. So you really have to just plan out where it is you can sing things or say things in a song to help people come along with you and sing with you. Now, I admit it's going to take practice to get used to doing that, and you have to be comfortable with the song and know exactly what you're singing when you're singing it so that you're not stumbling over your own words or making it sound awkward. So definitely one of the first things you want to do is just be super comfortable with the song. Know it inside and out, have most of the lyrics memorized, or at least you know kind of where they're going and what they are so that if you are looking at a sheet, you're not stumbling over that and trying to think of what to say. So make sure to leave yourself enough time to say the first line or first couple of words or whatever else you're going to say in the middle of a song. The second thing you want to avoid is saying too much in a song, because remember, it's not about us, it's about the Lord. So when you're leading musical worship, you want to make sure that you're leading people, but just enough to get out of the way. You want to make sure they know where we're going, but you don't want to just keep singing every single line or leading them on every single line. So you can overdo it for sure. As I mentioned earlier, one of the big pluses to doing this kind of thing is that you're bringing your team along with you so that if you are going to call an audible, you're going to change something from what you rehearsed, your entire team knows where you're going. Not only does your band hear, okay, we're repeating a chorus, we weren't going to do that, but now we are, your multimedia team or those running anything front of house understand, okay, I have to get ready to do this. So you're not just springing new lyrics or different lyrics than what they're prepared to project or the band was ready to play or sing. They all understand where you're going. So it's a really big help. In other videos, we'll be talking about other things you can incorporate into that tool bag of yours as a musical worship leader. But for now, hopefully that gives you something to think about, something to maybe explore. I don't recommend you jump right into this the next worship service that you're leading, but I do recommend that in your room or in your practice space, give it a shot, because you're going to mess up, and that's okay. You just want to do it not when you're leading God's people in worship. And that's it. I hope it was helpful. If it was, I hope that you consider subscribing to the channel, and please hit like and share the video. That really helps us out. But as always, I want you to go out there. I want you to honor the Lord, but twist some knobs, flip some switches, and say some stuff. I'll see you in the next one.